having to study makes sense, but I have concerns about waking it.
Yeah, you've said that a few times now.
A normal Krogan is dangerous. This one was created and likely educated by a madman.
You know what? The tank is here. It's staying until I decide what to do with it. And that's that.
It's your decision, Commander. Just be careful.
Noted. The cargo hold is safe enough while I decide what to do with them.
Alright, Ring. We're to Mass Effect 2. I'm Yaxon. Got some renegade there. Squadron. Do some of that. I really don't like the upgrading levels and whatnot in this. I just don't fucking like it. I like the Mass Effects better. Alright. Activate the Krogan.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Okay. Krogan. Just more than maybe down here.
Access to life support is restricted.
Sweet.
Shepard, the men's restroom is on the port side of the ship.
Oh, she's a cutie. How old?
She'll be a year old next month.
Oh, you'll miss her first birthday.
Well, my family lives in New Canton.
That colony's on the edge of the frontier. Could be vulnerable to collector attack, couldn't it?
Exactly. It's most important that she have a first birthday. That's why I'm here.
Irony.
Did you hear? Another colony went missing. Ferris Fields.
Ferris Fields? Didn't Hadley have a brother stationed there?
Yeah, he's taking it pretty hard.
Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Sure. Just checking the weapon systems. You can never be too careful. I thought I'd seen every weapon in the galaxy in our fight against Saren. Mercenary work showed me otherwise. And now Cerberus rebuilds the Normandy with a few upgrades to boot. I wish we'd joined up with them sooner.
We haven't joined Cerberus. They're funding our mission. That's all.
Relax, Shepard. Just a figure of speech. I can't exactly doubt your judgment. Not after I got my own squad killed.
How did those mercenary gangs take down your team?
It was my own damn fault. One of my people betrayed me. A Turian named Sidomis. He drew me away just before the Mercs attacked my squad. Then he disappeared. Everyone except me is dead because of him. And because I didn't see it coming.
I'm not sure I understand. What happened exactly?
Sidonis asked for my help on a job. When I got to the meeting point, nobody was there. By the time I got back to our hideout, the mercs had killed all but two of my squad. And they didn't last long.
Do you know where Sidonis is now?
No. His trail vanishes after he leaves Omega, but I'll keep hunting. I lost my whole team except for Sidonis. One day I'll find him and correct that. Thanks for coming by, Shepard. I've got some things to take care of.
Where the fuck is it? That's why I'm 2-1 now.
Commander Shepard, I watched the Normandy crumble with you on board. It's good to see you alive.
Nice to see a familiar face, Doctor.
I feel the same. I wish more of the original crew could be here. The kind of trauma you endured would have changed most people. But not you, I see. Welcome back, Shepard.
Do you have everything you need?
I believe so. This medical bay seems very much like the sick bay on the original Normandy. Only thing missing are my private reserves. I even had a bottle of Ceres Ice Brandy that I was saving for a special occasion.
I'll keep an eye out for a replacement bottle.
Oh, you needn't. It's expensive, and we have much larger concerns ahead.
Doctor, you've been with the Alliance for years. Why leave now?
After the Normandy was lost, the surviving crew was reassigned. I was stationed at the Mars Naval Medical Center, a very respectable position, but it wasn't on a starship.
Colonial military life isn't for you?
I've spent most of my life on warships, never knowing what the next mission might bring. I'm used to the hum of engines, the creaking of bulkheads, that subtle vertigo when the momentum dampeners kick in. Life planetside is just too static, too boring.
There's a very good chance this mission will be a one-way trip. Are you prepared for that?
I've been through the reclaiming of Shanxi, the Skellion Blitz. We survived the Battle of the Citadel and the destruction of the Normandy together. I've lived a full life. No regrets. I'd like to make sure the crew gets the same opportunity.
You're not the Cerberus type, Doctor.
I don't work for Cerberus. I work for you. On a mission that may be crucial to the survival of the human race. I have faith that your dealings with Cerberus will be ethical. I trust you, Commander.
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Commander.
Access to the AI core is restricted.
Says right there in the description. Maybe if I would have read that, then would have been a little bit better off.
Oh, yeah. That's a model of the Varrican. Turian frigate. Hell of a ship. I led a mission to bring that thing down from the inside with just 5 men and whatever guns we could bring. No chance of success, but we did it. Everyone died but me. So I made out like a bandit. My first impossible mission as an independent contractor. There's been many since, but nothing so goddamn sweet as watching that Turian warship crash planetside. Thinking about past missions. Got a minute. You might learn something. So you knew Archangel from before. Interesting. Knew a lot of men taking jobs to kill the son of a bitch. I never saw the point. You and I wanted the same thing. A whole lot of mercs dead. Hell of a sniper, though. And he kept himself alive with all the mercs in Omega after him. That ain't easy.
Yes, you really can't have a conversation with him. Yeah, that's good for space in the shitty skybox or whatever it's called we're in. That looks extremely fucking close. Okay, where's the Krogan? Guessing it's down the steps.
Subject is stable, Shepard. Integration with onboard systems was seamless.
Can he see anything in there? Does he know where he is?
Unlikely. Current neural patterns indicate minimal cognition. Barring ship-wide power loss, the nutrients in the tank could sustain him for over a year.
Any idea how dangerous this guy is?
He is a Krogan, Shepard. If you were asking whether he is actively hostile, I don't have the necessary data to answer. O'Kear's technology could impart data, not methods of thinking. The subject may know of his views, but would not necessarily share them.
What can you tell me about this guy? Anything unusual?
The subject is an exceptional example of the Krogan species, with fully formed primary, secondary, and tertiary organs where applicable. No defects of any kind, aside from the genetic markers of the genophage present in all Krogan. I cannot judge mental functioning.
Stand by. I'm gonna open the tank and let him out.
Cerberus protocol is very clear regarding untested alien technology.
I won't be second-guessed on my own ship, by my own ship. Do it.
Very well, Shepard. The controls are online. The switch and consequences are yours.
I'm Commander Shepard, and I don't take threats lightly. I suggest you relax.
Not your name. Mine. I'm trained. I know things. But the tank O'Kear couldn't implant connection. His words are hollow. Warlord, legacy, grunt. Grunt. Grunt was among the last. It has no meaning. It'll do. I am Grunt. If you are worthy of your command, prove your strength and try to destroy me.
You wouldn't prefer Okir or Legacy?
It's short. Matches the training in my blood. The other words are big things I don't feel. Maybe they fit your mouth better. I feel nothing for Okir's clan or his enemies. I'll do what I'm bred to do. Fight and determine the strongest. But his imprint has failed. Without a reason that's mine, one fight is as good as any other. Might as well start with you.
I have a good ship and a strong crew. A strong clan. You'd make it stronger.
If you're weak and choose weak enemies, I'll have to kill you.
Our enemies are worthy. No doubt about that.
That's acceptable. I'll fight for you.
I'm glad you saw reason.
Huh? Offer one hand, but arm the other. Wise shepherd. If I find a clan, if I find what I want, I will be honored to eventually pit them against you. Shepard.
Just checking in, making sure you're acclimatizing.
Humans talk too much. Like the tank. Come back later.
Anything in your tank imprints that can make use of the resources we've found?
Might have something I could put together. Don't know how useful it will be.
Alright. Krugan shotgun. Let's continue on now.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal. Alright, we need to go to the mass relay. Garrus and Zed again, I guess.
Thank you.
Hopefully nothing goes wrong here.
Welcome to the Purgatory, Shepard. Your package is being prepped and you can claim it shortly. As this is a high security vessel, you'll need to relinquish your weapons before we proceed.
I can't do that.
Everyone stand down. Commander, I'm Warden Kirin, and this is my ship. Your weapons will be returned on the way out. You must realize this is just a standard procedure.
It's my standard procedure to keep my gun.
Let them proceed. Our facility is more than secure enough to handle three armed guests. We're bringing Jack out of cryo. As soon as the funds clear, you can be on your way. If you'll follow me to out-processing for the pickup, Commander.
Let's go.
Cell Block 2. As you can see, we keep tight control over the population. Each prisoner's cell is a self-contained modular unit. I've blown a few out the airlocks as an example. The ship is made up of 30 cell blocks identical to this one. We house thousands of criminals. We can put the whole place in lockdown on a moment's notice. Nothing goes wrong here.
Can you tell me about Jack?
Cerberus hasn't told you? Jack is the meanest handful of violence and hate I've ever encountered. Dangerous, crazy, and very powerful. He'll see soon enough.
How'd you end up running this ship?
I was in law enforcement on Palavin. And got sick of seeing criminals escape out into the galaxy to carry on with their crimes. Bounty hunters aren't dependable.
You're not hiring the right ones.
Eventually, I hit upon this idea. Keep the criminals in space, and the galaxy is a safer place.
You do this because you think it's necessary?
Every day I see the worst sapient life has to offer. Governments are soft, unwilling to make the hard choices. Someone had to stand up and make the galaxy safe.
Maintaining a population this size in space can't be cheap.
We can cut corners that governments can't, and each prisoner brings in a fee from his homeworld. These individuals are violent, and their home planets pay well to keep them here.
What happens if the homeworld doesn't want to pay?
We explain that we can't maintain the prisoner without their help, so we'll be forced to release him back onto his homeworld, at an unspecified place and time.
So it's an extortion racket.
You don't have to agree with my methods, but don't question my motives. These are despicable people, and I'm keeping them locked up.
Let's get on with this.
Have there been escape attempts?
We're in space. They have nowhere to go, and they know it. But still, we exercise extreme caution. These are dangerous individuals. We have many ways to control the population. I'm going to confirm that the funds from Cerberus cleared. Out-processing is straight down this hallway. Just keep going past the interrogation rooms and the Supermax wing. I'll catch up with you later, Shepard.
Away from Took.
Hey, guys, over here. Let me ask you something.
If you're buying prisoners, can you buy me? Man, I don't care where you take me or what you do to me. It's gotta be better than this.
We're here for Jack.
Jack? Forget what I just said. I don't want to go nowhere with you.
I thought this ship was a prison, not a market.
Sometimes people buy cons so they can do some punishing of their own, if you understand. Warden sells us to whoever can pay enough.
So, what are you in for?
I killed a few people. Only about 20 or so. And I blew up that one habitat. Small time compared to most of the guys here.
Tell me more about Jack.
The worst trouble you ever saw. Mixed with some crazy and way too much biotic power. That's all I'm saying.
Why are they interrogating that prisoner? You know something?
Nah, that's Bimmy. He don't know nothing. He offed someone in the showers yesterday, I think. The guy he killed was worth a lot to the warden. Yeah, Sucks to be Bimmy right now.
They're going at it pretty hard. Do they ever kill prisoners by accident?
I haven't heard of anyone dying. Warden can't make money off us if we're dead. Funny thing, though. The more a guard does it, the meaner he gets. So they rotate him through.
What's it like here?
Bad. And you gotta watch out. Damn, but someone's always after your stuff. Your smokes, clothes, your pride. I haven't taken a shower in 3 months.
I should go.
Wish I could go.
Is there something I can do for you?
There's no excuse for beating a prisoner who can't fight back.
This is a massage compared to what his victims went through.
This degrades you as much as him.
We have orders.
You're not important enough to make your own decisions?
I admit, I sometimes get tired of this. Does this really get us anything useful?
Stop this. For your own sake.
Yeah, you're right. Call it off. At least for now. The package will be at out processing just down the hall.
I hear the screaming in my head. It's nice, yeah.
Out processing is through the door on the far side of the room.
Shepard, you're more valuable as a prisoner than a customer. Drop your weapons and proceed into this open cell. You will not be harmed.
You talked up your noble intentions with this prison, but it turns out you're a criminal like the rest.
Activate systems!
Let's get Jack out of the freezer.
Let's go!
Shepard. If you hack that control, every door on the cell block opens.
It's the only way.
I'm doing it. Be ready.
To get down there.
All right. I don't see here.
Warning. Warning.
They're attacking Jack.
I'm gonna have some of this.
Shepard, the warden has locked down the area behind you. You must find another exit route.
Warning. Power plant damage has led to overload. Core systems failure imminent.
Down.
my shields!
You're valuable, Shepard. I could have sold you and lived like a king. But you're too much trouble. At least I can recapture Jack.
Not happening. You're a two-bit slave trader, and I don't have time for it.
I do the hard things civil governments are unwilling to. This is for the good of the galaxy.
Jumpy cut. Oh fuck. Okay, yeah, I remember what we're doing. Yeah, it's going over this way. Don't kill me. Aw, you motherfucker, getting close. I don't like people who get close. I'm gonna fucking take you out, you piece of shit. How did it not kill your fucking ass? I'm obviously gonna sniff the food. Make sure I'm ready before I destroy this. Yeah, putting on the full auto one. God damn it.
Bad situation, and I'm gonna get you out of here.
Shit, you sound like a pussy.
I'm not going anywhere with you. You're Cerberus.
I'm working with Cerberus for now because they can help me.
With them, for them, I don't care. You show up in a Cerberus frigate to take me away somewhere? You think I'm stupid?
This ship is going down in flames. We can get you to safety, and we're asking for your help.
We could knock her out and take her.
I'd like to see you try.
It might just come to that.
You'll have to kill me. Look, you want me to come with you? Make it worth my while.
Tell me what you're thinking.
I bet your ship's got lots of Cerberus databases. I want to look at those files, see what Cerberus has got on me. You want me on your team? Let me go through those databases.
I'll give you full access.
You better be straight up with me. So why the hell are we standing here?
Move up.
Welcome to the Normandy, Jack. I'm Miranda, Shepard's second in command. On this ship, we follow orders.
Tell the Cerberus cheerleader to back off, Shepard. I'm here because of our deal.
Miranda will let you into the system. Let me know what you find.
Hear that, Precious? We're going to be friends. You, me, and every embarrassing little secret. I'll be reading down in the hold, or somewhere near the bottom. I don't like a lot of through traffic. Keep your people off me. Better that way.
This was the briefing room. Where is the debriefing? Debriefing room? I have no fucking clue.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the Combat Information Center. Here, the crew receives sensor data and coordinates gunnery and damage control efforts. While Normandy is flown from the bridge, during combat, the commanding officer issues orders from the CIC.
Alright. This is where the debriefing room is. Alright.
Shepard, I think we have them. Horizon, one of our colonies in the Terminus systems, just went silent. If it isn't under attack, it soon will be. Has Morden delivered the countermeasure for the Seeker Swarms?
Not yet.
Let's hope he works well under pressure. There's something else you should know. One of your former crew, Caden Alenko, is stationed on Horizon.
Last I knew, Caden was Alliance. Why is he out in the Terminus systems?
Officially, it's an outreach program to improve Alliance relation with the colonies. But they're up to something. And if they sent Commander Alenko, it must be big. I suggest you take it up with him.
We should send a message to the Citadel. The Alliance can give us reinforcements.
Not until you investigate. I don't want the Alliance getting in our way. Once you have the situation under control, I'll send the message personally.
Send the coordinates. We'll head straight there.
This is the most warning we've ever had, Shepard. Good luck.
Joker, set a course for Horizon. I've got to go see the Professor.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Tell me you have something.
Yes.
Alright, but with that, I'm going to end this one off here. Nice, long, pretty long part. Should be around, like, an hour-ish. But, yeah, anyways. Next part, we will, continue on Horizon. So, yeah, but anyways, in the XCon, and I will see you guys in the next one.